Welcome back to my channel, and today in my video, that is on the big data analytics, I'll be discussing regarding the Flagellet-Martin algorithm, that is the FM algorithm. So this algorithm basically does the approximation. So it is an approximation algorithm which basically calculates the distinct elements in a stream in such a way that it is given to a single pass filter, you can say, or any hash function. In this example, we'll take h as the hash function, and then in a logarithmic manner, it computes the space consumption is done, or the space optimization is done, which is a very good advantage of this FM algorithms over many other algorithms in big data. So this name of this, like Flagellet-Martin, basically comes from its creators, that is the Philip Flagellet and G. Nigel Martin. So this is the algorithm. So to get started, there are four basic steps for this algorithm, that is for the FM algorithm, for counting the distinct elements in a stream. So first of all, we'll pick a hash function, that is h. Now this hash function will map each of the n elements to at least log n to bits. Now this is useful for mapping each of these elements into characterizing into binary format, like this streams is in stream data usually consists of the bits, that is zeros and ones. So this hash function will do that job. Next is that we'll create one stream element, not this element, that is a stream element. We'll compute this trailing number of zeros for RA, that is R is the trailing number of zeros for this A element, and with the trailing number of zeros in HA. So in this particular hash function, we'll calculate how many number of trailing zeros are actually there. Next, we'll record this this result into R. That is, record is basically done by computing the maximum of all the number of trailing zeros, that is max of RA seen. Next, based upon this record, we'll calculate the estimate. That is, estimate is given as E is equal to 2 raised to R, and this will finally give the equal number of distinct elements which are there in that particular stream. Now these are the four steps of the Flagellet-Martin algorithm. Next, we'll go to the probability distribution. Now this algorithm is initially was used for database applications for a probabilistic counting algorithm. So we'll calculate the probability of this algorithm. So this algorithm, this probability is given by for a particular HA, that is for a particular hash function, it at least for I number of zeros, that probability is 2 raised to minus I. That is, you can write this as 2 by I. So this, for this particular probability for that particular given HA, which ends in at least I number of zeros, like see, in a binary format there are two variables, that is 0 and 1. So in this, for considering, like we consider only zeros in this, so for denoting zeros we give it as I. So that probability is basically 2 raised to minus I. Next, if there are m different elements, then the probability that the record R is greater than or equal to I is given by 1 minus 2 raised to minus I, this entire thing raised to m. Now keep in mind that this expression, or 1 minus 2 raised to minus I, is a probability that that particular hash function which you are using. Now hash function would be different, it would be MD5 or SHA or any other hash functions. Now this is the probability that that particular hash function which you are using for solving your problem ends in fewer number of I zeros. HA ends in fewer zeros, and this entire thing which you see, that is 1 minus 2 raised to minus I, the entire thing raised to m, this is the probability where all HAs ends in fewer than I zeros. So this is all HAs ends in fewer zeros. Now, this expression, we can simplify it further. Like the estimate or the value of 2 raised to minus I is very much small. So, we can write it as 1 minus e raised to, so it is like a logarithmic expression, e raised to minus m into 2 raised to minus I. This e raised to 1 minus e raised to m into 2 raised to minus I. So this expression, by using the Taylor's expansion series, we can solve it further. So only for demonstration purpose, I will write it as like if 2 raised to I is very much greater than m, then this expression evaluates to be 0. And if this expression is less than or equal to m, or the value of 2 raised to I is very much less than m, then this evaluates to 1. So this is the algorithm and the probability distribution for calculating the various values while you are solving the problem. Now there is one variation which is involved in the FM algorithm. That is, this estimate which you are getting from this, that is e is equal to 2 raised to r, in principle, like in the real world example, this estimate is infinite. It could be any number of values. Like when we estimate, or when we record this r, or this r when we increment it one by one, like this, when this r tends to r plus 1 or r plus 2, then the probability value actually halves, but the value which you are getting from this, or estimate, the distinct number of elements from the stream, this value doubles, or the revenue of this value will go on increasing. Now, if there are workaround, now in this algorithm, there may occur many number of workaround. Workaround is basically recalculating the streams, or if recreating if any new work is done, or if any overhead has come, then we have to recalculate it. So this workaround involves creating many intermediate samples. So the samples are nothing but the outputs which we are getting. So finally we have to combine this. So combination is basically done by taking the average of them and taking the median. Now average is done by figuring it out or rounding it off to a very large value, and median is done by calculating all values as to a power of 2. Now how this is done? Now since you will get a particular sample, that is partition, then you will have to divide it into small groups. Now this partition will have the complexity of big O of log n, where this n is the size of the universal set which you are getting. Now after you divide this partitions into small groups, then take the average on this small each individual group. And after you take the averages on these individual groups, then you can take the median of these averages. So this is the variation which we do in the FM algorithm. So this is the overall concept or an idea about the Flageolet-Martin algorithm for counting the distinct elements which are there in a string. So hope you enjoyed this video. If you found this video helpful, please hit the like button. And if you haven't subscribed to my channel, please subscribe. Thanks for watching this video.